Does anybody else just sit out in their garage and look at their golf cart and think of all the stuff they want to do to it? God, I got so much money I'm going to put into this thing. Probably going to have to go back to stripping. Showed up today. I'm pretty excited. I was gonna go buy a tire mounter, but I found a place here that's about 2 miles from my house that would do all four for $40, and that would just save me from having to buy another piece of equipment to keep in the garage at the moment. Maybe when I get a bigger shop, I'll get one, but for now I'm just gonna pay the $40 and go get it done. So let's check out the wheels. I think y'all like them. I like them. I'm a big wheel snob. I like my wheels. Oh yeah. Look at all that fancy packing that they put in there. Make sure you don't scratch them up. Kid at Christmas, man. That's what I'm saying.
Oh, look at that. That's nice and shiny.
So we got the GTW Bravo. 14-inch, it's got the bronze insert. When I was designing this cart in my head, I saw these and I thought, man, I need a set of those. And I'm really glad I went with this wheel. There are some other awesome wheels I know that are coming out here soon that are even nicer than these, which is kind of hard to say because we sell these and I like them. But I'll probably keep them on the cart, because the idea that I have in my head for the paint job and everything else already kind of flows with it. So we're gonna be mounting some 28-inch tall Super Swamper TSL’s on these 14-inch wheels. Guys, I used to run 10-inch wheels and 12-inch wheels, and I tell you what, man, I've really gotten to where I just like the look of the 14s better. And I'm sure one day the 15s will catch on a lot more than they already are. I've seen a couple sets of 15s that look pretty awesome. I like having the 18s on them, to tell you the truth. I thought that was probably one of the coolest looks that we've done. Hell, Travis has a cart with 20s on it, or 22s. I think they're 22s. Big old tires and wheels. So, here's our Super Swamper, made by Interco, made in the US of A. That's what I'm talking about. They're a lot narrower than I thought they were going to be. They're only 8.5 inches, but man, they look really, really narrow. I don't know if that's 8 inches or not. That's what she said. See, I'm showing tread width right now at 6.5, and this is not mounted. Internal 4, so those things are they're gonna push out wide on those wheels. That might actually look pretty killer. Look at that. Look at the difference in that. Yeah, I'm gonna say it's gonna look pretty killer though. I guess we will see.
far from optional. Family comes first. It's only logical. Let's go to work. My wife is sexier than yours. No comparison.
All right, so I gotta tell y'all what happened when I went to get the wheels and tires mounted. They got the tires on there, but then they called me and said, hey, we can't get the beads to seal. The tires are too narrow. I said,
huh?
Do I need to come show you guys how to do this? And they're like, well, we're not going to charge you. I said, okay. I get up there and the guy was like he just couldn't figure it out. And he said, can't get the bead on it. I said, all right, so let me show you how to do this. So I went and got a ratchet strap out of the back of my Expedition, went over there, threw it over the tire, ratcheted that thing down, and then I said, air it up. Then they charged me $40 for it. Y'all believe that? So hard finding good help, man. Jeez.
What? What an idiot. Oh, what a loser.
All right, so got the wheels and tires on. I think it looks pretty killer. I'm really happy with the setup. 28-inch tall Super Swampers. They look pretty killer on this cart. So we had a hurricane rolling through, and I had to get the cab put on the chassis so that I could get it in the garage. It's not as light as I thought it was going to be, but it was a two-man job. We got it done. I know I didn't get to film it. Like I said, I was in a rush, but it's all right. We're going to be pulling this cab on and off several times. We got to get all the audio sorted out. I've got so much audio going in this thing. It's unbelievable. I got to figure out how we're going to put 3 amps, an iPad, 4 subs, and probably, I can't decide if I'm going to do 10 or 12 speakers. Probably going to do 10. 10 in that little cab is going to be rocking. So, but we're going to build a custom dash that looks similar to this one. Kind of like it'll be sort of like the one that Corey had on his green cart. We're gonna put an iPad in it, iPad Pro with that, and we're gonna flush mount it in. Get y'all's ideas. Y'all think we ought to go landscape or should we go vertical with it? Y'all let me know what you think. I hadn't really decided yet. Also, I can't decide on what type of box I want to go with. Do I want to build a ported box? Do I want to have forward-facing outfire speakers? Do we want to do a fourth order or sixth order bandpass and do a blow-through design? And there's so many options. We got 4 digital design 6-inch Redline Series subs. I used to have them in my F-350 and they pound, especially with a 4,500 watt sound cube amp. So gonna be running the big 4,500 watt for the subs, and then probably 2 1,000 watt for all the mids and highs. Plus, I'm debating on some other electronics that we're talking about putting in it. You know, we got, I don't know how many lights we're gonna put on. I know I'm gonna run a 42 inch light bar in the back and in the front, and I'll probably run, I don't know, at least 4 if not 6 rigid cube dualies that I'm gonna either put in the dash, or not in the dash, in the grill. So we gotta do that. We gotta build the flatbed for the back. The body, I hadn't decided what we're gonna do on the body yet. I'm trying to find somebody that has a body for a workhorse. At the end of the day, I might end up having to build my own custom one. Also, I can't decide on what cow I wanna run. There's so many options. Everybody has their opinion. Y'all let me know what y'all think. Should we run the L6 cow? Should we run an ST cow? Should we go get a custom fiberglass cow? Ooh, I think the Ford Bronco cow would look pretty sick on the front of this thing. It's a lot of work, but it would look killer.
You're gonna see some serious shit.
All right, guys, in the next upcoming videos, we're gonna be talking about a couple things in order to get your cart up to where you want. I realize that not everybody's gonna build a cart as crazy as this one, which is why we also have the Silent Killer cart, which it will be four-wheel drive, but it's going to be more of a basic cart. It will have a bunch of custom touches to it. We're waiting on parts to come in. We're going to start that build here pretty quick. But next video, we're going to talk about budget, you know, where to buy, how to buy, what's the best place to buy, golfcartsmodified.com, just saying. Anyway, there's lots of stuff that we want to cover. I'm going to show y'all how I set up my board for the way I want to build my cart. You know, there's so many ideas floating around in my head that I'll remember and I'll forget. And the best thing I have found to do is just make you a board of how you want to do it. So I'll take a bunch of pictures and a bunch of stuff that I write down. I'll have it on my door. That way every day when I come out, I can see it and I'll be like, okay, this is definitely what I want to stick with. This is what I don't want to do. It's just an easy guide. It's cheap. It doesn't cost much. And it really helps. So thanks for watching. Stick around. Check us out. Hey, if you're not on our YouTube page, you know, make sure to hit that bell and subscribe. Check out our group page. We're almost 30,000 members. It's all golf cart people. It's all it is. It's all we do is golf carts all day, every day. Check that out. Also, if you want to follow some of the pictures and builds that we do, check us out on Instagram. Guys, we appreciate it. Remember to go check us out at golfcartsmodified.com. Y'all have a good day, and remember, go modify.